This example uses the tooth growth dataset that is built into JASP. You can find it by opening the data library, selecting ANOVA, and then scrolling down to tooth growth. We're going to be constructing a two-way analysis of variance. Under ANOVA, go to ANOVA, because both of our variables are between groups variables. Len is our dependent variable. Sup and dose are our two independent variables. This will give you the standard ANOVA source table, but there's usually a few other things that we want in addition to that. In this particular case, because dose has three levels, and because the dose variable is statistically significant, we should conduct a post-hoc test for that variable. Under post-hoc, I'll select dose. Again, we just need it for dose because it has three levels. We don't need it for sup because that only has two levels. The default is a Tukey post-hoc test. I usually also like to construct a descriptives plot. I'll put sup on the horizontal axis and dose as separate lines. So here we can see for the largest dose, when dose is 2000, there's really no difference between the two supplement methods. But for the smaller dosages, 1000 and 500, there is a difference. The OJ results in a higher outcome than the VC. I'll also go to additional options. I want to request the marginal means for both variables individually, and then also the interaction between the two variables. I'll ask for the descriptive statistics. That'll give me the mean and standard deviation for each combination. And finally, the effect sizes. For a factorial ANOVA, we usually want to look at partial eta squared. And that will actually show up back at the top in the ANOVA source table.